Ruth also had to position herself strategically to be found by Boaz. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Okoyemi Goddess, and on this channel I talk about love, relationships, marriage, lifestyle, and basically everything fun. If you're new to this channel, thank you so much for stopping by. For my returning subscribers, thank you so much guys for sticking to this channel. Please, if you're yet to subscribe, do well to subscribe, thumbs up this video, and also share with your loved ones. So guys, today I'll be talking about how to position yourself to be found by a good man, a godly man. Or basically how to just position yourself in a strategic way to be found by your type of man. So let's just get right into today's video. So ladies, the first thing you need to do in order to position yourself to be found by a good man is to know the type of man you want. So I know we have fundamental things that we're looking for in a man, like, is he God-fearing? You know, is he a believer? Is he a man of faith? Is he generous? You know, is he a giver? Is he hardworking? Is he kind? And so on and so forth. But besides the fundamental things that an average Christian should always want in a man, there are like other things that are like relative. So what I want in a man besides the basics would definitely be different from what you want in a man, you know, besides the basics that I just mentioned. So you have to know what you want in a man. What are you like looking for in a man exactly? It's not something that is general to everyone. It is relative. The fundamental things are like what is common to every believer or every Christian. But I just believe that every lady would also have like what she's also, you know, looking out for in a man. So you have to know the type of man you want, know what you're looking out for in a man. Then when you know what you're looking, you know, out for in a man, the second thing you need to do is to pray about it. Like, prayers have been underrated. I say it a lot of times. We usually like underrate prayers. Pray about it. God listens, he hears, and he also answers prayers. Tell God what you want in a man, you know, besides the basics, besides the fundamental things. Tell God what you want in a man. I want this, I want this, I want that. God answers our prayers. So I don't want you to get caught up in this impression that, oh, you don't tell God the type of man you want. No, please pray about it. He answers our prayers. So the first thing is know the type of man you want, and then you pray about it, which is something that is very essential for every believer. So the third thing you need to do is you need to mind the company you keep. Ladies, this is 2020. You should be in the company of, you know, women of like minds, women of like passion. There's really no point being around women that you don't share the same vision, you don't share the same mission, you don't even, you know, share the same values, you don't share the same views and opinions. Why should you be in a company of women that you guys have like opposite values, opposite, you know, goals and all that? So be mindful of the company you keep. You have to be in a company of women who are also on a journey to becoming better, like women of like minds, women of like passion. These are the kind of women you should have around you. So be careful of the company you keep. Be mindful of the company you keep. That is very, very essential in order to position yourself strategically to be found by your dream man. Okay, the next thing you need to do is, ladies, this is 2020. You can't be stuck in your house hoping that Mr. Right will knock on your door and be like, hello, I'm Mr. Right. That is not possible. You need to go out. Ladies, you need to go out. Like, I know some of us are like introverts. Some of us like to be at home. I'm also like that kind of a lady. But you have to go, you really have to go beyond all that. You just have to find a way around it, even if you don't like going out, even if you're not like the outgoing person. For this purpose, because you want to be found by a man, your man will not find you at home. He won't knock on your door. He doesn't even know you exist. So you have to go out there for you to be found by your dream man. Do you understand? So ladies, go out. Please go out of your comfort zone, go out of your home, go to places, travel. If you can afford to, even travel outside your country, please do. If you can't afford to, even within the premises of where you live, look for, you know, fun spots to go to. Just go out. Go out so you'll be seen by, you know, prospective men. So that's another thing you have to do. You have to go out. Next thing you have to do is, ladies, you have to dress well. Appearance, you know, goes a long way. Your appearance really, really matters. So you can't say you want to be found by a good man, by a godly man, or by a man that has all those, you know, attributes that you're actually looking out for in a man, and then you will go out and then you're dressing shabbily. You've prayed about it, now you're going out, but of course you're not dressing properly, you're not dressing appropriately. So how do you want the man to be attracted to you? He will never be attracted to you if you dress shabbily, if you're not like well spoken, if you're not like soft, if you're arrogant. So you have to work on your appearance, and it's beyond what you wear, it's how you wear it, and also how you talk, how you present yourself, your hair. Generally, your appearance matters a lot. So work on your appearance, ladies. You can't just afford to dress shabbily, you know, as a lady who is, you know, hoping to be found by a good man. Dress and dress properly, dress appropriately, dress for the occasion. So know what you wear for a particular occasion, and just be neat, be well coordinated, talk properly, sit properly, you know, just maintain the basic etiquette that is expected of everybody. That would also go a long way to help you, you know, in order to be found by a good man. So ladies, another thing you have to do to be found by your type of man is to go to places where your type of man would visit. So I know I've mentioned it earlier that you should go out as a lady. Don't just sit down at home hoping that your you know, your dream man or your type of man will knock on your door and say hello. No, I know I've said you should go out, but it's beyond going out. You should go to the right places as well. So you have to go to the right places. You already know what you want in a man, you know, besides the basics and the fundamental things that I mentioned earlier. Probably you want a businessman, probably you want a professional, I wouldn't know, but you know the type of man you want. So go to places where those kind of men go to. For instance, you want a businessman, you want a godly businessman, go to places where godly businessmen go to. You want a godly professional, go to places where godly professional men go to. So you have to go to, you know, the right places. So it's beyond going out, you know, going to hot places, hot spots, fun places, traveling. Go to the right places where your type of man will be found. These kind of places that, you know, the man you're hoping will find you. The type of places that this kind of man will go to. So that's the essence of, you know, doing your own research. You have to find out places that your type of man would always visit, or would want to visit, or would likely visit. So that's that about going to the right places. Okay, another thing you have to do in order to be, you know, found by your man, or in order to strategically position yourself to be found by a good man, is to be the kind of woman your kind of man wants. I know this sounds interesting, right? So you're wondering, what do I mean? Okay, so I'll break it down. You know the type of man you want, right? So you have to be the kind of woman that kind of man would want. So for instance, you want, I'm trying to create a scenario now. So for instance, you want a man who has a PhD, for instance. You want a man who has a doctorate degree, but then you don't have a formal education. So how do you want a man of that, you know, of that status to get attracted to you? You know, it might be a bit difficult, let's be sincere, it might be a bit difficult. I'm definitely not saying that people who have formal education do not get attracted to people who do not have formal education. Of course, I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying it would also help you, you know, to be found easily. Imagine if you're looking out for a man that has a doctorate degree, and of course you also have, even if it's a bachelor's degree or, you know, a first degree, you also have that. So automatically you are already a spec for him, because you have at least a certain level of education. So that's why you also have to be the kind of woman your type of man wants. Of course, I only use that as, you know, a scenario, as an example. I'm not saying all women are looking out for a man that has a doctorate degree. I'm just using that as, you know, as an example. But you know what you want in a man, so you know better how you have to, you know, how you have to appear for that kind of a man, you know, to, you know, get attracted to you. So it might not even be in terms of education, it might just be you upgrading yourself, working on yourself. It might be the way you talk, it might be the way you interact with people. You might want to learn, you know, basic etiquette. Just upgrade yourself in such a way that your kind of man will get attracted to you. So be the kind of woman that your type of man would want to marry. Okay, ladies, so the last thing you have to do now is to ensure that you never join these social media movements where they say men has come, all men cheat, there's no good man out there, all men are same, men are useless, men are not faithful, men are not loyal, men are not serious, men will disgrace you, men has come, you know, all those kind of phrases that you see or read on social media, you should never join those kind of movements. You want a good man. So you should confess that. Mind what you say. Don't join this kind of movements where they say, oh, we don't need men because men cheat. All men cheat. Well, you know, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. There's this like movement on social media where a lot of people like to condemn men. They say you can't find a trustworthy man. You can never find a loyal man. You can't find a man that will be trustworthy, that will be reliable, that would not cheat. So they will kind of generalize that all men cheat. All men are not loyal, you know? All men are irresponsible, blah 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 blah. Please don't join that movement. You know, when people say such, you should confess positively. So when they say all men are scum, all men cheat, you say my man is not scum, my man, you know, is not a cheat, my man is godly, my man is responsible, my man is reliable, my man is trustworthy, my man is good, my man is generous, my man is a giver, my man loves God, my man fears God. You know, those are the things you should confess. Don't confess what the world confesses. You should confess what you want in a man. So you want a good man, then confess it. My man is a good man. My husband is a good man. Confess it even before meeting that man. Say it out. Speak it into existence. Don't join, you know, those negative vibes that we see on social media where they say all men, you know, cheat, all men are irresponsible. No, you should never join that kind of a movement, the men as come movement. Don't join that. If you want to be found by a good man, you know, if you want to be found by a godly man, if you want to be found by a responsible man, then you have to confess it. So say what you want in a man. My man, you know, he's a responsible man. My man is a provider. My man loves God. My man fears God. My man is a giver. My man is a tither. Whatever it is you want in a man, say it out and confess positively. So ladies, those are the few tips I have for you in order to be found by a man, or if you're trying to position yourself strategically to be found by, you know, your dream man, these tips would help you. So these tips will really help you, ladies. Don't forget that Ruth also had to position herself strategically to be found by Boaz. She wasn't sitting at home, stuck in her home, hoping that Boaz would come and meet her at home. No, she was gleaning on the field and she strategically positioned herself to be found by Boaz. So this is very, very essential. All these tips will help you in order to be found by your type of man. So ladies, I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. Don't forget to please subscribe, like this video, and please click on the notification bell so you always be notified whenever I put up videos on my channel. And if you have other tips on how to be found by a man, please drop them in the comment section. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.